while the North Sea wind it blows, Thor's river eternally flows. Downwards, onwards, winding to the raging sea, where the cycles of time carry traces of the ancient ways. Along the dark and distant paths to future gods and unknown races. But the oar is now cast aside, the sail is tattered to threads, and the bones of the seamen lie amongst the flag-stained mounds on the coasts and hillsides, where the forgotten homes and sacred sites lie scattered. They're silent now, but the whispering wind carries a distant echo of the family songs, where dagger and brooch were once forged and the ruins were cut in birch and pine. And our sun-baked and wind-carved faces that feared nothing but the gods of nature, whose slightest notion could cast ill or plight at the mere crack of thunder or spear of fire in the northern sky. And as the waves stirred higher and the skies darkened, the longest nights of dragging pain and fear entailed, as the screaming windmills, the rocks and waves crash high and loud, hoping the tall necks will appear once again round Holborn Head. What our memory claims for 50 years hides a distant, hidden land, where men of fame, the tales they tell, their faces so well kent but new so long lost. Their skills so hard practiced, but now nothing but lore and dust, and a distant